Hey, J.R. Phelan here with South Jordan Horse Lessons, teaching you how to put on a saddle, a western saddle to be specific, on my horse Duke here. Okay, first of all, what we do here is we put on the saddle blanket. These get a lot of different styles, obviously. On this one, what we're going to do here is this leather piece here is built in here specifically. See how this one's kind of more towards the front here and less leather here towards the back? That means that we want to put this up more towards the withers here because you want to get ready for that front cinch and that rigging D. You can see where the indent is there. We're going to be strapping this. So, we put this on. The key on this this blanket here is you want to make sure you're covering up these withers here. This is a high impact spot here that can wear and can get saddle sores on the horse. So we want to make sure to cover that spot. Okay, I've got a classic western saddle here that's got all the stuff here. It's got the stirrups, it's got the breast collar, it's got the front and the back and the flank cinch on it so that we can show you how to all do this. So one of the things I like to do is before I'm putting on the saddle, is really make sure everything is kind of cleared off on this right side of the saddle before you put it on, especially this one. It's a pretty heavy saddle. And so we want to get everything clear as we put it over on the horse. Okay, I'm going to set it up here. A couple of the things fall over. That's all right. Here's the breast collar. We're going to lay that down on the other side. Now what we want to do is we want to make sure we got everything kind of set on both sides. So what I'm going to do here is let's move Duke around so that we can see this other side. And on this other side, we want to make sure that everything's laying correctly. They say that you always saddle from the left side, and that is correct. But you do want to make sure that all of this is laying flat, laying correctly. So how I've done this is I've taken the front and the back cinch here, and I just loop them through this. There's a lot of different ways of doing this, but then connecting it here up here to this I guess it's not called the latigo holder, but this other holder up here. And now we can undo those and let those hang down. Now here's a classic thing right here we need to make sure is flat. This front cinch here, you can see that's kind of tangled up. So you want to make sure that's laying real flat. Get all your stuff laying flat on this side so that you have no issues. Okay, now I'm going to scoot him back out here, ask him to move. Okay, now we're on our left side here to do all the saddling here. I like to take this stirrup and put it up here over the horn so we can get this out of the way. I call this the latigo or the leather strap here for this front cinch. This is the first part I do on the saddle. Now I reach under here, grab this this cinch part here. I'm gonna feed this down through here. This is the part that is probably the most critical on all of it, not probably, I think it is. You want to make sure, this is the key part here, is this middle part has to be right under the middle of the horse's barrel there. That's the key, and especially as you tighten it up, you want to make sure that that's really centered. So you see how I've fished it through one time through the deal, and I've come back through the cinch once. I'm gonna even do a second time here and slide through here. You can see I've got a lot of slack. I might even do a third. Let's do a third just to see how that goes. And we're gonna tighten it up our first time here. But you can see we're kind of slowly getting more and more. We want to make sure that we're still centered. Still looks fairly centered. Now how I do this, there's a couple of different ways. You can do a knot or whatever. With this cinch, I do have a little buckle here. And so what I'm gonna do is I am gonna slide this buckle through the hole here. You can see that that is now caught into the latigo or this leather strap. Now what I'm gonna do to get this set straight is I'm gonna put my fingers in here on this leather strap in between on the sides. And I'm gonna pull this to get this so where it's notched real flat here. Now you've got this big long extra strap. This is the Latigo. You stick this up here into the Latigo holder is what this is called. So we're going to fish this in. How I've always done it is I've just gone from the outside down in, just so that you get a nice, flat, smooth deal here is what I like there. Okay, the next thing I do is we've got the breast collar. So the breast collar, not all saddles have this. This is an add-on that pretty much most of them can get on there, but the reason why I like this, and there's a lot of different ways. Sometimes folks will just have a nice little hook to just be able to hook it in. I always strap it on because I've got a few different horses, so I have to adjust the width and everything of this. So this is just a regular buckle here, and we're going to slide this back through and then back again through here. So what you're kind of trying to do is minimize that areas of friction and just make everything nice and flat. Now we've got this breast collar deal here that we're going to hook in here onto the cinch. You can see we've got a little bit of extra space here. I can actually take that and tighten that up here too. So I'm going to do that one. This one I don't do as much, so it's going to be a little bit of stiffer leather. Well, we'll just leave that alone for now, just so that we don't eat up the time of the video here. The last part, though, is that you've got this flank cinch. Now, notice on that front cinch, we did really tight. You saw how tight I did this. On this one, you don't want to do it too tight. I did that one time, and the horse was bucking and farting and all that kind of stuff if you do it too tight. So what you do here is you want it snug, though, back here. Because this is another name for this is the old crap strap. So if your front cinch has an issue, breaks or something, this is the strap that you want to have that will keep you at least up the top of the horse until you can get that front cinch fixed. So we've got that, and then we've got our cinch connecting cord here, or I think this is just a little connector strap here, so you can keep these so this doesn't go too far back as you're adjusting around in the saddle. So you kind of do a double check, make sure everything's laying flat, laying good, and there you go. That's how you saddle a horse. Thanks for watching SouthJordanHorseLessons.com.